Hello lads, and welcome to another Uneducated review, this time with a crazy space adventure developed by Typhoon Studios and released by 505 Games. If you've heard the name Journey to the Savage Planet before knowing about this game, and you are a fan of sci-fi, you might have thought that this is a B-movie from the late 50s. The name certainly does imply that, and I am sure it was chosen on purpose. The game is a space adventure which does not take itself seriously. In fact, it's completely bonkers. You play a lad sent by the fourth best interstellar company to an unknown planet to explore and catalog data. As it always is, you have crash-landed on the planet and you first need to find resources to repair the ship. During gameplay, your constant companion is the ship computer, voiced by a female, who continually makes somewhat witty comments and sarcastic remarks, although after a while her sadistic and cynical comments start to get slightly annoying because they become repetitive. Now, as I said, the game doesn't take itself seriously. Everything is exaggerated and a caricature of other games. Starting with the intro with its FMV sequences, to the commercials about grub, the slimy substitute for all food, and right to the very first alien lifeforms you meet, which looks suspiciously similar to the avians in a certain mobile game. You see parody everywhere you turn. The game looks like an offspring of No Man's Sky and Spore, and conceptually it lies somewhere in between. The game atmosphere is quite cynical, because you have contrasting elements in action, like a colorful lush planet inhabited by cute life forms, which then your snarky computer says you must shoot, of course, in order to harvest their minerals. I know they are trying to make this funny, but I must admit I felt sorry at times for the little buggers. Somehow their attempt to make the game witty and funny feels after the first few hours a tiny bit forced. Especially the comments from the ship computer, which were obviously written in a way so as to sound quirky and ironic, become cumbersome after a while. Also, comedy which hits you with the subtlety of a steam-powered train is not a great comedy. And here I especially mean some bits like the remark about capitalism, which was not only cringy, but also ironic, because to my knowledge the game developer got bought by Google shortly after announcing the game. Therefore, in my humble opinion, the humor would have been much better if it wasn't so overexposed and if it only came infrequently. Forced comedy aside, how does the game feel, you may ask? Well, it is an adventure with light RPG elements, which means you run around, explore, gather resources and solve puzzles. All this is relatively easy, I might add. The puzzles, for example, are usually in the form of an artifact which you must unlock by activating a few switches. And to activate the switches, you just have to scan the different switch symbols, which you can find right there, not even a few meters away. This is some preschool grade puzzle complexity, really. To be honest, some puzzles are harder than others, but still, sometimes finding out how to get to some bloody platform was much harder than any puzzle in the game. And the same can be said about enemies. There is a disparity between trash mobs, larger predators and few bosses which are a bit harder to kill. But the overall feeling is that once you figure out the secret behind it, it all becomes easier and is usually similar for all the harder enemies. In this regard, the game does feel like a lightweight console shtick which was then ported to PC. This console flair is obvious, starting from the awfully low field of view, which almost gave me nausea at times, and then to the fact that you have an aim assist option in the settings, which was even activated by default. The former you cannot even change in the settings, but thank God at least you can turn the latter off. I really wouldn't know who on earth would even need aim assist with a game which is relatively easy, but to then have it in the PC version is a special kind of retarded. I know they put it there probably in case you played with a controller, but then again, you know my opinion about controllers as well. The visuals of the game are interesting. The graphics are colorful, even oversaturated, which in this case suits the crazy concept of the game with all its really alien flora and fauna, I guess. Textures are quite good, naturally a bit on the cartoonish side, and the view distance is quite massive. I had all my graphics settings set to epic and there didn't seem to be any frame loss visible. The music and sound are passable and well integrated into the overall atmosphere of the semi-open world. This world, which is comprised of a sort of floating islands really, is divided into different maps or sectors if you will. During gameplay you get several missions which you have to absolve. These lead you to finding different alien artifacts and minerals which then you can use on your ship to 3D print items, like a gun or a grappling hook among other things. And your ship, the Javelin, serves as your typical home portal. On the planet itself you will find several teleporters scattered around which you must activate to be able to use them. Now this back and forth teleportation does get tedious after a time, because you feel like it breaks the immersion too often, since it is almost always in the form of teleport from Javelin to side A, get one item, teleport back, then teleport to side B, get one item again and teleport back. I guess they did this because, as is typical for a console game, you have no real save slots, so the game saves automatically when you teleport to the ship. You would also think they did this so that you would not lose too much gameplay if you accidentally died after playing for an hour or so. But here's the thing, death is an arbitrary thing in this game. I mean, you can die when the game wants it, and then you are cloned and revived on the ship again. After this kind of death and some snarky remark from Echo, your ship computer, you can go back to where you died and pick up your loot. Near the loot you will probably also find your dead body, which you can then shamelessly bury. Other times, though, you can, for example, like I did, fall down into an abyss several times and then you just get teleported back to the edge again. Last time I saw this tosh of a gameplay mechanic was in a game where you played a gay wolf. Yes, really, a gay wolf. Which, by the way, I had reviewed, but then it got axed by TPTB. So I really abhor this gameplay mechanic. They should bring back real save slots. That way we can save before hard boss or in the middle of an especially tedious platforming performance and not force us to do it again and again from the very beginning, which does get frustrating. Now, the game is fun to play, at least after you get some of the upgrades, but after a while it does get slightly repetitive. This feeling is even more aggrandized by the fact that the actual exploration does suffer by overall dependency on combat. What I mean by this is that the game tends to drift more and more into FPS rather than discovery and adventure. This way you know each time you are to absolve a mission it will play in a similar scenario. You get the mission, you have to go to a certain place to pick up some item. Along the way you have to shoot a few enemies, then shoot the semi-boss who guards the item, then get back to the ship. You cannot, for example, try to sneak and get the item without having to fight the semi-boss, because the arc containing the item won't even open unless you kill the enemy first. This lack of diversity in completing quests does diminish the potential of the game. I think it would have been much better if more attention was given to the actual world, discoveries and alternative solutions instead of shooting your way through or using the same tactics over and over. What surprises me the most is that many people do not seem to even notice these things anymore. They do the same thing in the very same manner a gazillion times and are then pissed when someone points this out, which brings me to my next point. After I played the game and wrote most of the script, I watched several reviews ranging from well-known game portals to individuals, and the opinions differ quite substantially among them. You see, lads, reviewing games is an ungrateful thing. Because there are always people in the audience who feel grievances against the reviewers if they do not praise the games they like. Each time you review a game, you risk alienating part of your viewership. But as I have mentioned several times, I review games in an uneducated and independent manner. I do not get press copies, nor do I get paid by publishers to basically lie about their games. So, every time I review a game, it is my opinion and how I felt about the game. I do try to absolutely show you all the positive and negative things about the game, and I block my confirmation bias in these matters. So here as well. Journey to the Savage Planet is a game which intrigued me when it was announced. I was eager to play it because I like games that are space related in general. I now have to say that I had expected much more from this game. Not that the game is bad per se, but it is not quite what I expected. It can be a fun experience for a few hours, but it lacks depth, especially pertaining to aspects of exploration and variety. I saw similar verdicts by some other reviewers, which were then promptly disparaged in the comments by people claiming that they suck balls and that this game is great and at least a 9 out of 10. Well, it isn't. I do not use numerical ratings, but if I was, this would certainly not be a 9 out of 10. As it is now, I can say the following. If you are into some casual, lightweight adventure gaming with comedic elements and have a few hours to spare, you can get this. But if you are more into games which offer more depth, hours of entertainment and variation in gameplay, I don't think this will fulfill you, and I think you should maybe wait for other games which are more suited to your needs. That's it for today, lads. As always, stay uneducated.